You only need to notice your own emotions, count to three, have a little think, and that is a way to stop yourself spreading misinformation.
It feels like there aren't many things in the world that wouldn't be better if we stopped and thought about it for an extra few minutes.
Probably a tennis serve is not going to be better if you stop and think about it for a few minutes. But
Formula One driver. Yeah.
But no, I mean, very often, I mean, there's a reason why Daniel Kahneman's book is called Thinking Fast and Slow. You know, we're amazing machines at just reaching very, very rapid judgments and conclusions. And very often those judgments and conclusions are right. I mean, it's amazing how often they are right. But, you know, when we're out there in that media ecosystem, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, you know, they thrive on emotional reactions, whether it's anger or laughter or brings tears to our eyes. They thrive on that, and they thrive on these really fast twitch reactions. I mean, when was the last time that any persuader, whether we're talking about Donald Trump or Extinction Rebellion, when was the last time any of them said, just slow down and have a really good think? You know, that's not how it works. They want you to hurry up and feel something. And I would suggest that we need to not be rushed.
Tim, it feels like a real sad state of affairs, though, where every graph, every piece of information, every piece of data that we're served up in day-to-day life, there's this huge responsibility on us to check the axes, to think about it for 10 minutes. Am I being tricked? Have I got it wrong? I mean, it feels like 10 or 20 years ago, we could see a graph and trust it. And now, because anyone can publish a graph and put it in front of us, they've become useless.
Well, you know, as Donald Trump said to Bill O'Reilly, Bill, am I going to check every statistic? And I think the answer is, well, if you're going to share it, if you're going to add your voice to it, the answer is, yeah, you should check it. But, you know, that doesn't mean every footnote. It doesn't mean you have a second opinion, a third opinion. And, you know, no one has time for that. But just a brief moment of pausing. The bat and the ball question, it's actually not hard. But you do need to stop and think for a moment. And I think the same is true before you share something on Twitter. I know you know where babies come from, but there used to be this tale, that's what I grew up with, that babies come from storks. If a child is asking awkward questions of his or her parents, the parents would say, well, you know, the storks bring the baby in, draped from their bill in a blanket. That's where your baby brother or your baby sister came from.